Harry Potter movies stayed true to the spirit of the books and did really bring the story to life, but the movies cannot cover everything that the books do. Thus the movies do some characters dirty by cutting them from the story entirely. So in today's video we'll be discussing some characters that weren't in the films and who absolutely deserve to be there. This is obviously not a complete list, but I'll be making more and more in the future videos. Let's start with Charlie Weasley. Unlike the books, Charlie in the films appeared only briefly in a photograph of the Weasley family holidaying in Egypt and was mentioned only once in the Philosopher's Stone.
That's a Norwegian ridgeback. My brother Charlie works at these in Romania.
Because of this, Charlie is the only member of the Weasley family who is not seen on screen in person. Charlie Weasley was the second of seven children born to Arthur and Molly. He was born in 1972 and attended Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry in 1984 and was sorted into Gryffindor House like the rest of his family. Charlie showed a keen interest in the Care of Magical Creatures class and he loved especially dragonology from a young age, as Charlie used to try and turn the family pets into dragons. That's why after he left Hogwarts, Charlie went to Romania to study dragons. While people believed that he could have played Quidditch professionally, Charlie refused anything and focused only on studying dragons. In the first book, Charlie was the one who got rid of the baby dragon that was illegally kept by Hagrid. Because of Hagrid and Charlie's shared love of dragons, Charlie agreed to deliver the dragon to Romania. In the third book, Charlie was with the rest of his family for a holiday in Egypt. Charlie was portrayed by a British actor in the film adaptation. He appeared only briefly in the photograph. Charlie only makes a major appearance in person in Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire during the beginning of the book, as Charlie returned to the Barrow during the summer and traveled with the rest of his family to attend the Quidditch World Cup final. During the Triwizard Tournament, Charlie was the one who assisted in bringing dragons to Hogwarts for use in the first test and remained there during the test in case the dragons got out of hand. Charlie also attended his brother Bill's wedding to Floor and served as best man. In the movie, a young man with red hair is seen standing beside Nefedora at the wedding. It's likely that he's Charlie due to his haircuts similar to the one described in the book and the fact that he and Tonks attended Hogwarts in the same year and shared a friendship. Charlie took part in fighting during the Battle of Hogwarts. He did arrive toward the end of the battle alongside Horace Slughorn. But during this time, his younger brother Fred was tragically killed during the first half of the battle. This was something Charlie was initially unaware of. Fred's body was later moved to the Great Hall, where friends and family were devastated by his death. Following the war, Charlie didn't marry or have children as he was more interested in studying dragons than in forming a romantic attachment. However, he had many nieces and nephews through all of his 11 siblings. The second character is Winky. Winky doesn't appear and is not mentioned in the films. Winky was a house elf who served the Crouch family. Barty Crouch Jr. was a convicted Death Eater who had been taken out of Azkaban by his father and replaced by his ill mother, disguised by using Polyjuice Potion. It was Winky's duty to take care of Barty Crouch Jr., who had been placed under the Imperius Curse by his father, to prevent him from running away, which he did loyally and in secret for years. Winky played a big role in the fourth book, The Goblet of Fire. During that time, Winky persuaded Barty Sr. to reward his son for good behavior. As a reward for his son, Crouch Sr. reserved a seat at the 1994 Quidditch World Cup for Winky and himself and allowed his son to take his seat under the invisibility cloak. It was made to appeared that Winky was simply saving the empty seats for Crouch Sr., who was too busy to take the seats. Crouch Jr., who started to resist the Imperius Curse, stole a wand. Winky did miss this. Crouch Jr. was able to fight the Imperius Curse and gain some control over himself, but Winky resisted this by magically binding them together. Crouch resorted to firing the Dark Mark, the sign of Lord Voldemort, into the sky during the attack with the wand he had taken. Winky and Crouch Jr. were then both found by ministry officials. They could only see Winky with the wand Crouch Jr. had used to cast the spell, as he was still under the invisibility cloak and out of sight. The Ministry of Magic officials then blamed her for casting the Dark Mark with the wand, despite Winky claiming she didn't know how to. Crouch Sr. then freed Winky to avoid associating himself with the Dark Mark. Winky fell into a state of depression after being fired by her master, believing she had shamed her mother and grandmother before her. Dobby was able to get her a job at Hogwarts working in the kitchens, but she didn't do much work. The other house elves were embarrassed by her self-pity, though Dobby attempted to take care of and looked out for her. Winky slowly improved over the years and participated in the Battle of Hogwarts along with the other house elves led by Creature against the Death Eaters. After the war, Winky would continue to work at Hogwarts and would eventually stop her bitterbeer addiction. However, it's unknown if she ever got over the losses suffered by the Crouch family. The third character is Peeves. Peeves the Poltergeist has appeared in all Harry Potter books along with the first three video games, but none of the films. It was a scene with Peeves was filmed in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone but was left on the cutting room floor. Peeves has lived at Hogwarts Castle since its founding in the year 993. He actually came with the building. Peeves has a physical form, though he's able to become invisible at will. He could also affect solid objects. Unlike the ghost, he could also be affected by magic. The Bloody Baron was the only being that Peeves took orders from. Peeves had a large amount of respect for the Bloody Baron for unknown reasons. Apart from the Bloody Baron, Albus Dumbledore was the only being in Hogwarts who Peeves was known to have shown any respect for, which was likely out of fear that Dumbledore could have him expelled from the school if he angered him. Peeves was seen and mentioned in multiple times in the books. Peeves did enjoy the pain of the others, like when he informed Myrtle that Hermione was talking behind her back, which made her run off crying, and he enjoyed her pain. During a defense against the Dark Arts class, Peeves stuffed a K-hole with chewing gum. Professor Lupin asked him to remove the gum, but Peeves refused. So Remus cast a simple spell which shot the gum at Peeves' nose. Peeves was the one who informed Dumbledore of the Fat Lady's location after her portrait was attacked. In the next books, his appearance was before the welcoming feast, where he dropped water balloons on the students. Peeves wasn't completely without loyalties. During Dolores Umbridge's attempt to take control of Hogwarts, he showed respect for his fellow troublemakers Fred and George Weasley, taking their part in wars to give Umbridge hell to heart as they fled the school. This marked possibly the only time Peeves knowingly obeyed any students. Peeves was actually on friendly terms with McGonagall during when she allowed him to borrow her walking stick to hit Dolores as she fled from Hogwarts. Peeves once apparated where Dobby, Creature and Harry were. Peeves then egged them on verbally, then throwing chalk on them to enrage them further. Peeves showed that despite his endless mischiefs, he was loyal to Hogwarts and willingly participated in the Battle of Hogwarts. He caused pain to the Death Eaters and didn't harm the fighter on Hogwarts' side. After the battle, he was heard singing a victory song to celebrate winning the battle. The fourth character is Regulus Black. Regulus didn't make any appearance in the films, except in Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, where he was portrayed by Tom Moorcraft in Slughorn's photograph. Regulus Black was born to Arion and Walburga Black, and was the younger brother of Sirius. He was a member of the Noble House of Black, an old wizarding family which probably started around the Middle Ages. He attended Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry in 1972 and was sorted into Slytherin House. Regulus was completely different than his brother Sirius, as his brother was later sorted into Gryffindor House, left home at the age of 16, and was subsequently disowned and burned from the family tree by his parents. Regulus, on the other hand, was admired by his parents for his loyalty towards his family and upholding their traditions. Regulus became a Death Eater in his youth and received his Dark Mark around the age of 16, but Regulus had begun to have doubts about serving as a Death Eater. One day, Voldemort asked Regulus for the use of his house elf creature, and Regulus eagerly accepted as he wanted to please his master. Voldemort used Creature to test the defenses around his locked Horcrux, leaving him to die afterwards. Creature was able to escape using house elf magic and told Regulus of what had happened. Regulus was the first person to learn about one of Voldemort's Horcruxes, after Slughorn of course. Regulus worked out that the locket was a Horcrux and was the reason behind Voldemort's immortality, and he later decided to destroy it. Regulus created a duplicate of the locket and placed a note inside for anyone wanting to destroy the Horcrux to find. "I have stolen the real Horcrux and intend to destroy it as soon as I can." He then ordered Creature to take him to where the real locket was hidden. Creature guided Regulus past the cave's defenses. Regulus ordered Creature to take the locket once the potion was gone and replace it with the fake one, then escape without him and find a way to destroy the Horcrux. Regulus drank the potion himself, and when he tried to get water from the lake, he was dragged to his death by the infirmary. Creature obeyed his master's final order and switched the lockets before escaping. However, despite Creature's best efforts, he was unable to destroy the Horcrux. The true circumstances of Regulus' death were entirely unknown to the members of his family, as he had asked Creature to keep the events at the cave a secret. Harry, Ron, and Hermione in 1997 came to know who Regulus Black was, and the mission he signed to destroy one of Voldemort's Horcruxes. The real locket was later found by them, and destroyed by Ron with the Gryffindor sword, finally accomplishing what Regulus had set out to do. During the Battle of Hogwarts, Creature, having gathered many of the schoolhouse elves to assist him, ordered them to fight for Regulus while wielding knives against the Death Eaters. "Fight! Fight for my master, the defender of the house elves! Fight the Dark Lord, in the name of brave Regulus! Fight!" Regulus Black died an expected hero. Sirius would have been so proud of his brave brother and taken a great risk for no personal reward. His is one of the most noblest sacrifices in the entire series. That was all for today's video. It won't stop here. I'll be making and explaining more characters that didn't make it into the movies. So please comment down below which characters you want me to make. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.